typical blustering wintry conditions in Bradford. What's not to love about the K2 Yorkshire Cup on a Saturday night? And it will be Bradford who will have first use of the ball. They will go from left to right. A loud shrill blast of the whistle from Marcus Griffiths, and we're up and running. And immediately Bradford are going to be brought down in a three-man tackle 25 metres out from their own try line. So it'll be Manny Wilde in at dummy half. He had a telling 70-minute contribution last weekend in that 26-16 win over Halifax. James Green wearing 10, takes the second carry. Wilde will come back towards the right. Mikey Woods brought down on the third, 10 metres shy of halfway. Bradford on their own 40 metre line, and it's going to be Wilde to Kirk. Kirk looking to somersault his way up to the halfway line, and that's the fourth tackle gone, and Bradford now just a metre or so inside that Dewsbury Rams half, as James Green, his second carry in this opening set of six, makes 15 metres forward. Bradford on the last tackle, 35 metres out from that Dewsbury. I think it's going to go to Kirk though, and here goes Kirk. Kirk sucks in that defence along the line towards Green. Green's wrapped up 30 metres out from that Dewsbury Rams try line. Three tackles remaining here for the Bulls, and Matty Wilde goes on a base run out of the half. Past the fullback, the support there, the Bulls are in. Great cover tackle, the remainder sherry from the line. But the danger not over yet, it's going to go back to Keyes. Keyes drops the shoulder, sucks in the defence, and the Bulls are in. It's Elliot Michella, who's had 4 minutes on the clock, and he's following up to the Bulls. First ball, and it's Key 2, got to the semi-final. Centre, which of course will soon be demolished for hotels and a leisure park, but Joe Keyes, that one will just creep in the right hand of the
right. That one might register on the Richter scale, and here he goes again, Trey O'Sullivan. Well, he's certainly enjoying his rugby league here under John Keir at the Bradford Bulls. And Dewsbury, perhaps have they got a score in them before half time, as Ryder goes down the middle. Ryder's away, Sykes in support, they have a try, they're going in underneath the sticks, and it is going to be 6-4, the kick to come, and in the blink of an eye, the Dewsbury Rams, they've gone for the first try, and it's 6-4.
Well, he might go himself, you know, because he's such a big lad, but you know, he's giving it to Sykes here. You know, Ricketts nearly caught Paul Sykes on the cover attack.
On this set of six, Paul Sykes along the line towards Lucas Walshaw. Walshaw's going to be brought down on the last tackle, just to the right-hand side of the post, 2 metres out, Sykes back on the 10, kick through towards the Bradford Bulls line, and it's Lewis Heckford underneath the sticks. He latches onto the ball, which was in the Bradford in goal area, and Dewsbury Rams, they're going to finish this first half with two quick fire tries. Chief architect, he realised Brandon Pickersgill out of position. Sykes then from in front of the post, the hooter's already gone, and Dewsbury Rams at half time in this K2 Yorkshire Cup semi in 1989, when Brexit was a distant memory. Featherstone 20. So Featherstone 14, Bradford Northern 20. It was at Headingley that afternoon. So Dewsbury, they'll have first use of the ball, and similar situation to what we saw last week with Halifax. Perhaps nearly coming up with an error on the first set of the second half. Dewsbury fortuitously palming the ball back towards their own line, and they've recovered the ball now. Ross Peltier will be joining us shortly. He's just been on the pitch at half-time doing the half-time draw, but it is Bulls Live and Bulls TV, and it is Bradford 6, Dewsbury 12. Michella opened the scoring for the Bulls in the 5th minute after, once again, another delayed cut-out pass from Keyes, but twice in the final 4 minutes of that first half. Best straight down the front of the Dewsbury Rams defence, wins a penalty for a high tackle. So Bradford, 20 metres out from the Dewsbury line, a full set of six, looking to level the scores up as Brandon Pickersgill goes on a mazy run towards the line. He's brought down 2 metres out. Flanagan out of dummy half. It's going to go along the line. Evans is over. Reece Evans opens the scoring for the Bradford Bulls at the start of this second half. And Dewsbury just couldn't contain with the speed of the play of the ball, and then the zip and zoom from Flanagan, Keyes, and Evans scores in the corner, 10 metres in from the far stand side. Penalty from that run down the middle. Anything Manny Wilde can do, the old stager can do himself. Joe Keyes, pressure on the kick, A crucial extra 2 points coming up here for the Bulls. That one sails between them.
You know, winning in pre-season builds a good momentum going into the season. And, you know, I think, you know, we've split our squad in half. You know, we've got no Jimmy Magdin. We've got a few players not out. No Cheese, no Lily. You know, we've got players left. So,
Bradford are going in again. It's Elliot Michella. Elliot Michella on the support. After taking the pass from Pickersgill, it was Pickersgill's break down the middle. The move started on the halfway line. And the Bulls, could they be on the way to face York or Batley next Sunday? Keys from in front. No mistake. It is the Bradford Bulls 18. Dewsbury though have come up with the ball. Perhaps that was justice served because it was Andy Gabriel who lost the ball. Michella has picked the ball up and Michella now has been felled. Sykes calls the referee straight over and Elliot Michella is down. Was a crusher tackle. Michael Knowles is it wearing 12. It's Paul Sykes in fact who said this one's not over. 6 points the difference. Sykes and Heckford, the two try scorers for the Rams, and now the touch judge has come on the far stand side. The referee. Yeah,
I'm not really sure what happened on the floor there, but does he give a.
George Flanagan's going for him up, 2 metres out from the Bradford line. It's going to go back in centre field. The kick comes through from Heckford and the Dewsbury Rams, they've got a try underneath the sticks. It's Andy Gabriel and Andy Gabriel will touch down. The kick from Lewis Heckford under the red, amber and black dot. This from in front. It's Bradford 18, Dewsbury 18. And let me tell you, Steve, the ages, a throwback to the Old Stonesbury Championship. And Bradford now, with a tackle remaining, find themselves in front of the post and they get a penalty. It's the Yorkshire Cup semi-final. And it's only the pre-season. Milnes, a crucial kick against the wind and rain. Bradford Bulls 18, Bradford Bulls 20. Are they going to come up with lightning on a filthy night at Oddsall? It's Sykes with ball in hand. The ball's been touched by a Bradford hand, but it's landed in the arms of Dan King. King kicks towards Flanagan. Flanagan smothers the ball. And it's full time here at Oddsall Stadium. Delight on the terraces and in the stand from the Bulls faithful. They've defeated the Dewsbury Rams in the K2 Yorkshire Cup semi-final.